Today I am fully concentrating on the management area or the treatment area. See, clinical importance of skin disease, as per my experience and as per a random clinical survey, 50% of the OP patients in general practice suffering from skin disease of an average Ayurveda practitioner. Among that, 10% is only incurable and 50% is curable. 40% is successfully manageable. So the scope of Ayurveda practitioner in the management of dermatology is 90%. How? See, in the text where the dermatological description we can meet in Kushtaroga, Visarpa, Vadashonda, Kshudraroga, Sriroga and Agadandra. You can see the references of the dermatological problem in all these references in our classical text. And common dermatological problem approaching to an Ayurvedic doctor, we can say Visarpam, Vicharthika, Kidibam, Vibhadhya, Sitma, Mega Gustam, Vyangya, Mugadoshika, Vidradi, Kodam, or in modern words, bacterial viral infection, fungal parasitic infection, psoriasis, lichenomanus, ichthyosis, eczema. Among that, seborrheic eczema and atopic eczema is more, and some cosmetic problem. Nowadays, the fungal and psoriasis and eczema is more. Also, the cosmetic problems is increasing to the overusage of cosmetic. Here, think our actually the tuk or skin is not properly identified. By the modern physiology or anatomy, we have studied something that we came to know that a bag is a bag for the body. And it's the most tortured organ in our body. But at the same time, it is the most obedient organ. You have studied it is the largest organ in the body, but it is the most obedient and it's most tortured because it suffers the beating and painting and scratching. Whatever we are doing, we can do, we will do it to the skin. But even though it is obedient, to some extent, it will obey. After that, it will exacerbate. That is the skin disease. And for a proper management, Charaka says, Rogat Jnanartham Evado Yatnagare Bishak Bhavid. Understand the disease first. Rogat Jnanam is very important. How Rogat Jnanam? Rogam Nidana Pragruva Lakshana Ovashayaptimi. Understand that Rogat Nidana Purvaruba Lakshana Samprapti and Ubashya. Or we can clinically, it is etiological diagnosis, morphological diagnosis, and clinical diagnosis. And in this way, if you are understanding the disease, the management is very simple. Nidana is very clearly stated in our science, especially Charaka. In that, Shidoshna Lengana Aharam Kramam Bukta Nishayavidam, all these factors is Navana Dedi, Malsyadi, Ramla Niveshya, all these Nidana etiological factors are still relevant from my clinical experience. Shidoshna Lengana Aharam, you see, nowadays in the Gulf area, the psoriasis and other diseases are increasing. The one important, in the Gulf, the people working in the AC, not only in the Gulf here, the people working in the AC, occasionally they are going outside. So at the same time, the body is subjected to different climate. That will alter due to the acclimatization process, the body is altering its physiology. And gradually, the chemical release leads to pathological change. All the etiological factors, and Vagbada is conceived. Midyahara Viharena Visheshana Virodina. Include everything. Midyahara Viharena Visheshana Virodina. Sadhu Nindava Danya Saharanata Bhapmi Karme Sadhyo. Praktane Viridamala. Simple psychological problem, psychological cause and intentional cause. That is Midyahara Vihara. Then Sira Prabhupada Dirjakta Tuklesi Gasra Amishan Dushayandya Sledi Girdya. Nishtaranda Tadobhi. This is Samprapti. Nidana and Samprapti. So, think what is happening nowadays, what we are subject to expose our body. These are the etiological factors of dermatology. We can think what is happening to the body. Now, just to visualize the Nidana and Samprapti, what our Acharyas tell, the etiological causes, different types of etiological causes, induce the dosha gaba, that is vada, pitta, gaba. Actually, vada is the controlling factors, and pitta is the metabolic factors. Gaba may be the protoplasmic and fluid medium. It causes the dhadu dushti, that is tuklesiga asrigamisham, that is the skin and lymph, blood, body fluids, and muscular tissue. And What is the etiopathogenesis? Due to the different etiological factors, there will be a formation of ama visha in the or in the endotoxin in the cellular area, and that causes the srodo dushti, that is obstruction of the metabolic channel. It leads to the kosha nasham or cell death, and lastly a shobolpa, the fluid accumulation in the dermis is happening, or we can call it a malasanjiyam or accumulation of endotoxin and medho mamsa dushti, kabasanjiyam and shobolpati. These are as per the samprapti shloka. Explore the samprapti shloka into visualize. So this is the etiological etiopathogenesis and emergence of disease. Again, what is meant by srodas? Srodamsi galu parinamam avadyamananam abhivahini bhavanti ayanarthena. It includes the internal transport system or the all metabolic pathway and receptor channels, even in the ion channel, and even the neurotransmission pathway include the srodas. And the srodo dushti is three types: rodham, sangojam and shobham, maybe obstruction, spasm and inflammation. So what is malasanjaya? Actually it is formation of ama visha or accumulation of endotoxin. In biopsy you think about the toxicosis condition or retention toxicosis condition. The toxic material accumulated in our body or cell is supposed to excrete from the body, or by maybe due to the incapacity of the excretory organ to excrete the accumulated toxins, or the accumulation, huge amount of toxin when accumulated in the body is not able to excrete, that toxin will accumulate in the cellular level here and there. That cause the toxicosis condition. That refers to the ama sanjiv or malasanjiv. So let us see what is happening in the skin or in the cellular realm. You think this is the homeostasis mechanism in tissue, samavastha in the skin happening. Here the arterial length is passing the venous end. The fluid, the nutrition and blood is coming to interstitial fluid, and the excretion to the venous end. Excess fluid will be maintained by the lymphatic system, and each and every cell is maintained by a proper pure interstitial fluid. Unless the interstitial fluid is not properly maintained, the cellular function will not be proper. Thus, our body have one single cellular cover, germinativum layer. That germinative layer should be work properly by multiplication. So when the interstitial fluid should properly maintain by its purity or its nutrition, that is happening when the arterial blood flow should be in the proper way or maintaining the arterial blood flow. That depends upon the recta vaha srodas, recta content of the recta, specific gravity of the recta, any minor change that refers to recta dushti. Cause defect in the interstitial fluid, and here the rasa recta vaha medho mamsa, everything is considered here. So what is happening in the pathological level? When the recta dushti is there, here the artery will be dilated. Srodo dushti is there, rodham, sangojam or spasm, that cause the dilatation of venous and lymphatic system. The interstitial fluid will be defected, the kosha nasham will happen. Or when it the cause is action internally due to mithya ahara vihara, as a morning, as allergy is describing the histamine, what will happen when histamine released? Automatically vasodilatation will happen. So gradually articaria, everything will happen. So external cause and internal cause. When the recta dushti is there, interstitial fluid will be defective, the kosha nasha will be, refers to in the dermis, the disease will come. Actually in the subtle level this is happening. Still in the subtle level the cell will adjust, homeostasis mechanism will be maintained within the cell and due to the external influence. But due to the chronic accumulation, what is happening? Cellular toxin, when to frequent exposure, there will be defect in the cellular metabolism. When the cellular metabolism is altered, the cumulative toxicity in the cellular area, it is not able to adjust with the external fluctuation and internal fluctuation, and gradually it will affect the mitochondria of the cell, which is the transmitter or which is the energy transmitter site of the cell. When the energy in the cell is lowered, the cell is not able to viable. So the kosha nasham is happening. And here even when the mitochondria energy vibration will be altered, it is altered the homeostasis mechanism in the cell, and the cell death is happening. Actually this is the basic pathology happen to almost all the disease. When this reaction or this pathological change happening in the liver, liver cirrhosis will come. When it is happening in the brain, brain damage will happen. When it is happening in the kidney stuck will be have. And when it is a lungs, and when it is a uterus, and when it is the ovary, it is the cause for the PCOD, it is the pathology of the PCOD. The same pathology is happening in the uterus, in the ovary, the PCOD will come. And when it is in the skin, different skin disease come. So this is the pathological change happening in the subtle level. And now think one example. This is a case of ichthyosis case. This is Ekagushtam, Ekakya Mahasram, Asvedam, Malisa Shakalasam. This is actually the patient from Kasaragod, toxic induced, and the very endosulfan induced area, patient is from Kasaragod. Actually, in the modern way, it is called hyperkeratosis. The hyperkeratosis due to toxin, here the pathology is release of antigen, and the cell-mediated immune response will be there, and inflammation of the lymphocytes, cytokines, IgEs, etc., perform a degenerative keratinocyte, and that is a colloid formation. And due to that, the increased steroid sulfate will be released. That cause the decreased membrane coating granules here, and hence the cell-to-cell adhesion is more. So descamation mechanism is defective, and retention ability formed cell, that is called the ichthyosis here. In our sign, it is a Ekagushta, it is Vata Kabaja. What is happening in the Vata Kabaja stage? The Vata Kaba is there in the Vata Pitta Kaba. Here, due to the Rasadadu Dushti, the Jalam Dadu is decreasing, and Vayu and Prithvi Duda is increasing. So, due to the Vayu and Prithvi Buddha, the Vayu Ruchada of Vayu is causing Shoshana of the Prithvi Buddha, cause the Shoshana in ichthyosis or keratoma-like disease. This is the pathology or samprapti happening in our body in this type of disease. And one more. See, this is the histopathology of psoriatic patient. Here, in the psoriasis, the superficial layer, stratum corneum, stratum albigeum is loose. At the same time, in the dermis, you can see the lymphocytic administration and the capillary dilatation. Here, the fluid accumulation is there. By the superficial morphology, it is a dry lesion. But in the dermis, there will be accumulation of the fluid. And this is the chronic and acute eczema. In the acute histopathology slide of acute eczema, here the lesion is very oozing and very soggy. Here it is dry. And here, the epidermis, in the epidermis is almost fluid. In the dermis also fluid accumulation and lymphocyte accumulation we can see. Even though the chronic stage the skin is dry superficially, in the deeper side, even though the superficial epidermis is dry, stratum granulosum is dry, in the dermis, lymphocytes and vascular dilatation we can see. That means in the dermis, in the deeper side, ulceration will be there. That is called Tolblesiga, Asrgamishan, Dushayanda, Shradigirtya, Dushta, Kushta, Mushandida. So in the management, due to this, even though the morphology in the superficial it is dry, deeper side, it will be accumulation of the fluid. That is our Ajarya says, Idi Doshe Vijide Ande, Tokse Shamanam Behi Plebadihidam. Without clearing the deeper side of the dosha, when you are applying any external application, it will be increased due to the excess of ulceration. So this is very important in the management. And for the reference, you just think about the Shobha Nidana and the Samhitas also, contact dermatitis you can see from the Sushruta, and the concept of allergy formation of dermatology problem in Samhita you can refer. And see, an example, this is the cumulative toxicity of the meat. By the etiological fact, daily morning and evening he is taking chicken daily. And this is a 10 years chronic problem he are suffering. And actually this is from some seborrheic pustular psoriatic lesion. Actually all the signs and symptoms of psoriasis we cannot say. Actually we diagnose it is a vijarthika, because the all the signs and symptoms like sagandu petakashiyava lesigade vijarthika, and the cause is over accumulation of the toxin in his body. This is the papillosquamous disorder, that is sitma gushta, clearly due to endotoxins. And this is a parthenium dermatitis, chronic allergic eczema. Actually, the patient is from Coimbatore. And this is allergic eczema due to kungumum, usually cosmetic, or not only cosmetic, all the even the sandalwood also artificially prepared is causing this type of problem. And here, allergy due to some flower. And this is a polyester allergy, cloth allergy. Nowadays, polyester dress is causing allergy severely. And this is dermatography allergic disease. And this is nowadays scleroderma, the autoimmune disease, and although the collagen disorders are increasing due to the improper food habits and the lifestyle, and several patients are approaching in the because in the modern there is no treatment for this, only antihistamine and steroid. So they are approaching for alternative therapy to Ayurveda people. Here, contact dermatitis due to chappal, different chappals. And you know, chappal is not causing any problem, but the chemical added in the tanning process of the leather is causing this process. So when you are using adipoli cherupu, cause tolipoli disease. For the Malayali people, adipoli will cause tolipoli. So don't use any other adipoli chappal. And this is another chronic vijardhya or padugavisha usage of chappal. And this is our spectacle allergy. Spectacle allergy, you can see here, same spectacle allergy contact. This is ornament allergy, colis allergy. This is detergent allergy, housewife's problem. Now this is solar dermatitis due to the sunlight. And this is heat. Actually, the patient came from an Ayurvedic hospital after a peachil. When the heated oil caused the peachil, this problem happened, heated oil allergy. The patient came from an Ayurvedic hospital after the peachil of 7 days. Maybe due to the oil or maybe due to the heat. And this is conduct of the dusparsha, that is plant allergy. And this is, I told you, this actually the patient was suffering from some sort of vesicular bulbous disorder. One Vaidyan or one Ayurvedic doctor given gulguldikta grida, and this allergy came. And now this is connect, allergy to the chemical allergy due to watch strap of a watch. Now this is a heat allergy, acne vulgaris, due to the heat and some powder. This is mukadushya or solar effect. Actually the patient was suffering after the chicken pox. She applied some ointment for removing the black spot of the chicken pox, and that ointment caused this type of allergy. Actually, post chicken pox solar dermatitis, she is working in the university as a clerk, still she is working. And this is kachya, kachya di kachya sanna deshesu. But the problem is due to deodorant allergy, due to the spray. Different spray is coming, different spray. That is the allergy due to the spray. And this is actually very interesting, you have to listen. Actually, this is the patient came to me, occasionally happening this type of blisters formation. And after thorough investigation, she is telling that after application of oil on the head, she is actually the lady is putting oil on. And that oil is a number one oil seeing in the media for hair growth. And after that, I searched all the internet, and I came to know with several interrogation with the doctors, and there is a tablet called minoxidil. Have you heard about minoxidil? No, it is used in the Canada. Minoxidil is a tablet used in the Canada for hypertension. And unfortunately or accidentally or fortunately, one doctor noticed that these minoxidil, when applied topically accidentally, the hair growth will increase. But when it is stopped, all the hair will be removing, automatically shedding. This knowledge they used, and this is the tablet adding all the oil in nowadays in the market, which will use for the increasing of the hair. Minoxidil. It is a highly toxic. When it is stopped, all the oil, when the oil is stopped, again all the hair will be shedding. And for the long term use, it will cause the scalp psoriasis and scalp cancer. That is the effect of minoxidil. Even the one modern MBBS doctor, modern shampoo is there with minoxidil. And almost all the where Kerala students, please note that in Kerala several oil are marketing in the form of different name for the hair growth. All the oil content is strong. One bottle costs 600 rupees. Minoxidil effect. And now this quadum or blister formation due to, I told you, Jadamayadi. Application of Jadamayadi in the wall shown in the case caused this type of allergy, quadum formation. Now this is atopic dermatitis or bala visarpam, karapan. There is 51 types of visarpam, and the bala visarpam is three types. Atopic dermatitis, infantile stage, adolescent stage, adult stage. And this atopic. This is napkin allergy, ahipudana, malovareba, suedadvya, like that. Ahipudana or gudaguttam disease is the napkin dermatitis. And now this is condom allergy, usually seeing to people, condom allergy. and this is sanitary pad allergy. This is a very, very chronic case, came from the Gulf. Still, she is cured completely.